All right, we're underneath the hood of our 1969 Dodge Charger. Looks like an RT, acts like an RT. Everything in it is like an RT, but it's not. It's not a factory RT. Did not start life as an RT, but it surely is now. It has a 440 Hypo motor in it, upgraded with an Edelbrock intake manifold, Holley carburetor, vacuum Holley instead of double pumper, power steering, four-pass aluminum radiator with an auxiliary transmission cooler for it for the 727 automatic that's in it, the correct shrouded electric cooling fan for it to keep this guy cool, new alternator, Presto Light distributor, brand spanking new battery in it, a cell coil, a cell wires, 1¾-inch, long tube headers, give it a lot of top end power and a lot of mid-range torque also. Good header system for these 440s. They love it, and so do the 383 cars. Again, underneath the hood, all intents and purposes, this guy is a real RT at this point. Runs, drives like one, very nice clean engine compartment. All the hoses are intact, all the wires are nicely run. Just a great, great car underneath the hood. We're going to go around it and show you the rest of it now. Hi, you're at Hangsters in Daytona Beach, Florida. And today on our deck, on our nice hardwood floor here, we have a 1969 Dodge Charger in RT trim, which means that it isn't starting life as a real RT, but it surely is now. It's got a 440 in it, got all the heavy-duty suspension, all the components that an RT would have are present at this vehicle at this point, and you're not going to pay an RT price for it either. Paint on the car is really, really pretty. It's a gorgeous blue color. The hood fitment is very nice on the car. The fender, the hood's nice. To the cowl area again is very, very nice. Driver's side fender the same way. You know, very, very nice. Hood mounted turn signal indicators, and they both function. They do work. Nice grille in the 69s. The 68s had a complete open, where 69 they put a little divide in it. Basically the same car, just a little different grille configuration. Chrome on a bumper is very nice. Bumper alignment is also very, very nice on this car. All the trim around the front is the same way, very, very nice. It's not an issue. RT designation with the Charger, where it belongs on the driver's side. Headlight, which these are peekaboo headlights. They do function, they do open and close. Front valance, same way, really, really nice. This particular car, they've eliminated the bumperettes on it to give it a wider, lower look without those additional bumper pieces going down. Really not needed. The bumper still has a lot of rigidity to it without them. Just an added look. Makes it look a lot wider. Parking light lenses are nice and clear. I don't see anything. Paint on this car is very nice. I mean, like, really nice. It's not fogged in any place. It's just really, really nice. Uh-oh, stone chip. There's a stone chip right here, whether something hit the edge of this fender or what, but there is a chip. It's not going to require any paint work. It's going to require a brush touch, and that's it. Other than that, the front end of this car is just sweet. Really, really nice. Let's see what's on the side. All right, down the driver's side of our RT-style Charger, 1969. Paint on the front end of this car is really nice, like it was on the hood. The side marker light, nice and clear, nice and shiny. The plastic lens is nice and clean. Fender lifts are nice on the car. Fitment of the front fender to the door is great, also to the rocker panel it is too. Torque thrust style wheels on this particular car, 18s in the front, 20s in the back. A lot of big tire and wheel under this car, and the Charger needed it. They had a lot of fender well to fill up, and they certainly did it with this set of tires. Again, 18s in the front, 20s in the back, discs in the front, drums in the back. Really gives this car a good look, especially with the dark centers and the polished machined outer rim. Really looks great. Again, you know, the fitment hood to the cowl area, to the door, everything's really nice and sweet. trim around the front windshield, and it is a tinted windshield in front. There's no marks or any bike marks or anything on it. All the stainless trim is nice around it. Top's just like glass. I mean, there's no marks or dents or dings or deviations or anything in it. It's really as nice as could possibly be expected. Drift rail, really nothing. There's really nothing there. Rearview mirror, driver's side, none on the passenger side. Chrome on the door handles, very, very nice. Door to the quarter to the, this is really a nicely fitted car. Very, very nicely fitted car. I could tell you about the wipers or whiskers or whatever you want to call them, but I can't because there are none. We ordered them, they didn't come in yet. There will be brand new wipes for the window channels, front and rear on this car. We have all four sets ordered. Everything will be installed in this car and new, you know, before it's ever delivered. So they're not here now. I can't tell you about them because I'm just telling you they're not there, but they will be. Quarter panel, same thing again, you know, just really nice, nice quarter panel. Tires don't hit, but they're getting close. There's some big rubber on the back of this thing. Hat rack in the back is nice. It has a set of aftermarket speakers in it. Back glass is real nice. Trim around the back window is very, very nice. Quick fuel Mopar gas cap, which they use in all the hypo cars. Quarter panel, again, you know, these cars are so long, but they're so charismatic because of the bottle, the Coke bottle shape to them, you know. It's the only car that ever had that. Really a great looking car. RT designation in the back, side marker light, really the way it should be. It looks really, really good. Bumper fitment in the back, it's nice and level. Just really a sweet looking car. It's real, I can't say straight because of the configuration of the body design of this car, but there's really no waves or warbles or anything out of place. The doors fit really nicely, you know, front to the fender and to the quarter panel. They both look great. Let's see what's out back. There's nothing on this side to report. Okay, back end of our 69 Charger. You can see the rear deck really fits well. Very well. The fitment, the gaps, everything on it is just as sweet as could possibly be. And obviously the paint is just gorgeous on this car. It's everywhere. It's just absolutely gorgeous. And we never even got a chance to really wet sand and buff this car. This is just the way we got this vehicle and detailed it out a little bit. But the car itself has a nice wet look to it. But I can only imagine what it would look like once we wet sand and buff it, which we probably won't do. It's going to make it look like a foot-deep piece of glass. Black around the rear section the way it should be. Yeah, a couple little tiny marks on the chrome just from age, but it is the original taillight, which is still very, very nice and shiny. Same thing on this side, just a little tiny bit of chrome patina, we'll call it, on that side, the same way as the other. Nothing that would make you ever replace it. RT designation in the back. The bumperettes are on the back bumper, but not on the front. It gives that wider look in the front without them. Bumper fitment is absolutely gorgeous on the back of this, too. It's really, really good. Really nice fitment. Rear valance, nice, clear backup lights, correct type exhaust tips. Really good looking back end of this car. You know, this stripe adds a lot of character to it also. The RT Bumblebee stripe around the back end of it. Great color combination with this blue and black. Let's see what's on the passenger side. Okay, starting with the back, again, our RT designation. Side marker light, really sweet the way it was on the other two. Fender lips nice and sharp yet. Trim around the back window on this side, same as the other side. Very, very nice. No dings or marks or any imperfections in it. Quarter panel. Tin's nice and sharp and the fender lips are all torn up from tires. The tires are getting close, but they're not touching it. Not even close to that yet. Again, this door is the same as the other one. Very, very nice fitment. Quarter panel to the door. Roof, the roof, just really, really, really nice on the car. Little tiny marker, not much of anything, but you'll never see it in the photos, but it's there. Again, no wipes on this side, but they're coming. They'll be there. Promise they'll be there before we sell the car. Passenger door, chrome on the passenger door handle, very nice. I love the way these doors fit on this car, the rocker panel to the fenders to the quarter panels. You're not going to get a better fitting setup than what's on this car. It's absolutely fantastic. A power antenna for an upgraded radio that happens to be in this vehicle. Paint on this front fender is the same as the rest of the car. It's very, very nice. Side marker lamp, same as the other three, just as sweet as could possibly be. It's a couple little, again, you're never going to see it, and it's not going to be there before we sell this. Before we deliver this car, we're going to get this thing wet sanded and buffed. There are a couple little imperfections in the paint, a couple little spots where a little speck of dirt or something there, a couple, I don't know if you want to call them fish eyes, but if you scuff it and hit it with a buffer, they won't be there any longer. The paint on this car is just really, really, really nice. It's a great color. Other than a couple little tiny imperfections, which I said are going to, they'll be eliminated once we get this thing wet sanded and buffed. It needs its wipes, which are en route. And other than that, you've got a really great 1969 Charger RT style vehicle with the 440 in it, 8 3/4 rear, which we'll see on our under chassis video there. They're very difficult cars to find, 68, 69, 70s. And we just had one we just went through the other day with a presentation. Very similar to this car, a little different color of blue, a little plainer than this. It's got a set of Kelsey Hayes wheels on it, which are original equipment. This guy has some serious rubber packed under it. It really gives it a big, massive look to it. Big, wide, massive look with the 20-inch tires in the back and the 18s in the front as opposed to the 14-inch. The interior's black. The appointments on the outside are black. The color obviously just jumps out at you. It appears to be B5 blue. I don't know if that's what it is or not, but that's the color that it chose to be. It's a straight car. It's a really solid, nice car. It does have a 440 in it. It performs. It looks. It gives you every indication that it's a real 1969 Dodge Charger RT. The only thing that tells it that it isn't is the first couple numbers and the serial number, and that's it. No one can know other than those couple numbers that it's not a real RT. And it's a price considerably less than any RT that we've ever had. So check it out on your Hangster's website. You'll be really impressed with what we can sell you this car for. Okay, we're in our 1969 Charger RT style car, blue, with a black interior in it. Great looking car. The dashboard's padded dash, nice and pliable on it yet. Sun visor's original equipment, and they're just like new. The headliner has to have been replaced. It is absolutely brand spanking new and stretched nice and tight as a drum. Back seats, front seats, everything matches. It appears to be the original interior in the car. The carpeting appears also to be the original carpeting. I don't see where it's been replaced. Feels like it's been re-dyed. They fade through the years, but it's nice black carpeting. Console's nice. Everything lines up on the console. Someone has added, in place of the wood grain in it, that put a carbon fiber type of material across the console. Really adds a nice look to it. Of course, the correct Mopar shifter. Steering wheel, no cracks or breaks in it. It is the original equipment Dodge wheel that came with the car with the correct center and horn ring. Aftermarket dash in this thing really, really gives it some pop. It's got a brushed, either stainless or aluminum finish the whole way across it, from left to right, is all brushed stainless. And instead of the regular gauges, it has a set of aftermarket Stuart Warner type gauges in it, black face, white letters. You have a speedometer, tachometer, temperature gauge, fuel gauge, amp gauge, oil pressure gauge, original wheel radio that came in it. I think it has, where the heck, there was a, Yep, a real high-end radio system with a brushed aluminum or stainless background also for this vehicle in the glove box. So you got a good modern sound system with a power antenna, upgraded speakers. Interior is very, very nice in this car. The seats, the door panels are just like brand spanking new. Remote mirror, the handles, the trim around, the window cranks, everything is nice and shiny yet. Everything functions on the dashboard. It's just a very, very nice, kind of an upgraded interior with the dash in it. It gives it a lot of sporty look with this brushed aluminum background with the black-faced black-faced gauges and the blue and black car. Really a good-looking car, a real high-quality car inside. It's going to make someone an absolute blast to drive. It's got tons of power with this 440. Sounds, looks, drives, acts, everything like a real RT, only for a lot less money. Here before we get started. Turn signal right, working. Turn signal left, working. Oil pressure gauge working. Speedometer is going to work, but we have to move first. Tachometer is working fine. Amp gauge is working. Temperature gauge is coming up. Let's see here. Wiper is working. Gonna pull right here and see what we got. Speedometer working. Better put some fuel in this thing. That's not working. Horn's working. Nice tone to it with those Flowmasters on it. It's not objectionably loud, but it's got a nice deep rumble to it. Real nice deep rumble. I have to be careful here. It's 35 mile an hour zone. Shifts as it should, it pulls just like it should. Just a real nice running car. Straight as an arrow down the road, there's absolutely no issues, everything functions. It's definitely going to need some gas before we get. Hi, you're in Daytona Beach underneath a 1969 Charger. Really desirable cars. These things are very, very difficult to find. This particular one didn't start life as an RT, but for all intents and purposes, it is now. It has a 440 engine in it, not a 318, not a 383, a definite 440. Fresh built motor in this car. Long tube headers. Of course, it has a standard heavy duty sway bar in the front. New spindles, disc brakes in the front, new calipers. Rotors are fairly fresh in it. New ball joints, new tie rod ends. Does have a set of long tube headers with a 3-inch collector, maybe 3.5-inch collector. Torque converter is new. The flex plate is new. The pan in front of the 727 is not on down here in the warmer climates. A lot of people leave those off simply to allow some air to go in and help dissipate some of that heat, cool that transmission fluid. It does have the original steel transmission cooling line still attached to it to go to a cooler in the front, but this is a definite help leaving that pan off. As long as you're not in the colder climates and using it in a salty, cindery road in the wintertime, it's not an issue leaving it off. No problem at all. It's a definite plus. The subframes on this car, real nice in the front. Going back, there are some superficial jack marks on this particular one where you can see it was jacked up through the years. You know, people lifted it up to do some work on it. And the same thing on this side, of course, you know, they were both jacked up. Some rocket scientists put a jack on the bottom of the fender lip, the fender well lip, and there's a ding in it, a dent in it. Again, it doesn't compromise the structural integrity of this car in any way. Too early in the morning, I guess. Transmission mount in the back appears to be fresh. The pan's not leaking, as you can see. The engine has no leaks whatsoever. Like I said, it's been a fresh rebuild. Heavy-duty torsion bars. Floor pans appear all to be original. I don't see any place anything's been replaced here in the floor pan area, even to where it transitions down onto the rocker panels. Still appears to be original. Original fuel line still intact, going toward the rear of the vehicle. 2.5-inch pipes transitioning out of the collectors. Again, the floor pans are very nice in the front, in the midsection of the car, toward the back. Everything appears to be just really, really nice. There's no marks. At least they jacked it up on the subframes and not on the floorboards, which we see on a few of these vehicles. They go, the 2.5-inch pipes go into two Flowmaster style mufflers. New brake line on this side, functional parking brake. Halfway through this car, I really don't see anything at all. 727 tranny, and again, you know, no leaks on that. I really don't see anything bad so far. New U-joint. We're good and halfway through it, and everything looks good, sound, structurally, and original. Most of this is an original vehicle so far. Let's see what's on the other half. Okay, second half of our 69 Charger RT style vehicle. Again, Flowmaster type mufflers on it. 2.5-inch out the back too, it looks like. Nah, make that 2.25. It was 2.5 in, 2.25 out. But it's brand new Flowmaster mufflers. The torque boxes are very nice on this car. There's no jack marks or dings or marks in them in any way, either side. Very, very strong structurally. The subframes, no dents on either side, left or right. Apparently the individual that jacked this car up in the front chose to jack it up by the rear differential, lifting the whole back end up of the car, you know, simultaneously, both sides. But there's no marks on the subframes at all there. Very nice curvature to the rear springs, leaf springs, and there's a nice curve to them. Rear differential is a heavy duty 8.75. U-joint in the back of the drive shaft that looks to be good and new. Does have a set of air shocks in the back. Newer shocks in the front, but there are air shocks in the back. Ventilated drums in the rear as opposed to the discs in the front. The floor pans appear to be the original floor pans. I don't see where they've been replaced at all ever through the years. Subframes, of course, in the back. I don't see any real marks on them anywhere. It does retain a lot of its original sound deadener from Mopar yet. Some of these cars, they got really carried away and put it on really thick. This one isn't real thick, but it does have it. The spring hangers in the back, nice and strong. I don't see anything at all on the back end of this car. Original gas tank in it yet. Original floor pans for the trunk in the back, they don't appear to have been replaced at all. Structural part of the frame across the back is nice and strong. It's a very good representation of a original 69 Charger body underneath. It doesn't show any other than some superficial dings from being jacked up through the years and some usage. It doesn't show any wear, any perforations. I don't see anything that was rusted anywhere on it. Floor pans, even in the back, are very strong and intact and appear to be all original. It's a nice solid car underneath. It's not a frame, totally frame off, if you want to call it rotisserie restoration. But the car is very solid, very nice car underneath. And it is a Charger, very, very difficult to find. But it's here at Hangsters.